Dear friends in Christ, I have the pleasure tonight to introduce to us Reverend Father Anthony Mado. Father, may God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Tonight's message is very powerful. Tonight's message touches principalities and powers. And tonight's message is for the baptized and the children of the light to be triumphant and to be victorious in the world of the occult. Tonight's message is a message of empowerment, a message of emboldenment, because we are fighting principalities and powers. Go into prayers, my dear brothers and sisters. We are at war with the devil. We are at war with Satan. And we shall never be tired of fighting. In the Middle East, people were fighting and are still fighting. In the spiritual realm, people are still fighting. We are fighting a just war. We are fighting a spiritual war. Because Jesus himself told us to pray in season and out of season. Jesus knew why he told us to do that. And today, the caption will be protection against principalities and powers. We shall be looking at Book of Daniel chapter 10 from verse 12 to 21. Go into prayers, my dear brothers and sisters. Cover your family with the blood of Jesus. Cover your family, your siblings, your children. Cover your job. Cover your life with the blood of Jesus. We are in the cult of Jesus. And we shall unravel the mysteries and the way to fortify ourselves tonight. Because many people have been living in fear. Many people don't know what is going on in their life. Why will my children be afraid when God created the world by just mere word? Why must we be afraid? Why must we be tormented and tortured? Why must we give up? Why must we be feeling the environment around us as vibrating and pushing us? We have to embrace for an impact. Heavenly Father, I invoke your spirit upon my children tonight on this line. I invoke the spirit of the church apostles to be upon each and every one of us tonight. I invoke the spirit of Elijah to come. I invoke the spirit of Moses and Elijah to arise, to fortify yourself. Look at Moses. Just mere staff of Moses was able to reduce the magicians of Pharaoh to nothing. Look at the staff of Moses was able to divide the Red Sea through the instruction of God. We have to look back in the Old Testament and know that our God is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Our God is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Our God is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Taking deep breath of life. Taking deep breath of life, my dear brothers and sisters. And breathe out your weakness and your fear. I don't want you to be living in fear again. Tonight is your deliverance night. Tonight is your deliverance night. If there is anybody that has been tormented or tortured by principalities and powers, give him this word tonight. Give him this message tonight. Tonight is a night of deliverance. Tonight is a night of liberation. Tonight is a night of divine protection. Tonight is a night of unraveling the mysteries, that you'll be able to be strengthened by the Lord. It is not myself that is doing it tonight. It is the Lord that will be doing it for you. It is the Lord that will be fighting for you. I'm just a main instrument administering the word of God. Father, Your children are ready and yearning and craving for you. Psalm 42, like the deer that yearns for honey stream. Even so, my soul is yearning and craving for you, my God. I stretch out my blessed hands upon my children tonight. As they receive the message of anointing upon themselves one by one tonight, may your hedge of divine protection be upon them. Shatter the principalities and powers and the witches and wizards that have been tormenting and torturing them. All the monitoring spirits will be going away from their life and their family. Father, I place my hands of blessing upon them, O Lord, that you will be able to place the hedge of divine protection and blessing upon them. Enough is enough for the men of the world. Enough is enough for principalities and powers torturing my children. For God is spirit. God is spirit. And Gospel of John, chapter 4, from verse 22 to 23, says, time shall come, and the hour has come, when the true worshippers shall worship me in spirit and in truth. We are worshipping in spirit and in truth in this land, and we shall fight the spirit of the evil forces. Devil shall run away from our families. Devil shall run away from your job. Why must you run away from your job? Why must you run away from your house? Devil is a liar. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Know it tonight. I'm talking to you, child of God. Claim back what belongs to you. Claim back your possession. Claim back your possession. Claim back your possession. Claim back your possession. Claim back your job in Jesus' name. Claim back your job in Jesus' name. Claim back what belongs to you in Jesus' name. Claim back your family in Jesus' name. Claim back what belongs to you. Don't run away. Don't run away. Don't run away. Don't run away. Start taking breath, deep breath, and look at that devil and say, hey, the hour has come for me to fight you. Yes, you have been running away because you forgot that you are carrying the image and likeness of God. But tonight, I'm creating that awareness in you, that you have that power by virtue of your baptism. You are co-heirs in the Lord's vineyard. By virtue of your baptism, God has empowered you. Remember this always. Remember it in the morning. Remember it in the afternoon. Remember it in the night. Remember it as you are driving to your work. Remember it as you are driving back home. Remember it when you are in the bus. Remember it when you are moving anywhere. Remember it when you are on the bed. Remember it when you are walking around. Oh, Father, I pray that this awareness will create that energy for them. Let there be spiritual synergy. Spiritual synergy that empower my children, that will help them to understand that they have the living God. And God is not dead but alive. Oh, Jesus, I stand before you in this tabernacle of glory, in this table of divine solution to present before my children this awareness and divine protection so that they will be fortified. Father, you prayed in Gospel of John 17 that all that has been handed over to you, no one will be lost except the one that chooses to be lost. I pray that you bless them, embrace them for their children. Sometimes children are afraid of the light and darkness. But you, my God, know that there's nothing there. You created light and darkness. Even little children, when you point at the moon, they will be crying. But the adults know that the moon does not even harm them. Father, can you show them the way again? Because you are the way, the truth, and the light. You are the Alpha and Omega. You created everything, including the Satan. Why would the Satan be tormenting your children? And so tonight, oh Father, I pray that you make that satanic power to be powerless, because we have the Archangel Michael, that will be fighting the hidden battle for us. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to embrace our impact, because tonight is a day for us. We have an appointment with Jesus today. You see, in Book of Daniel, chapter 10, from verse 12 to 21, you can see that dealing with principalities and powers need our Master Jesus. Dealing with principalities and powers need our Master Jesus, because he is the Alpha and Omega. The Master Jesus cult is the real cult that can shame and thwart the plans of the occult. This zone needs the Holy Ghost. Our families and our towns and villages, they are covered with the Holy Ghost fire. Child of God, remember that when doing your baptism, you were baptized with water and spirit. Remember that. You are baptized with water and spirit. Remember that you are a composite being made up of body and soul. Remember that you are the image and likeness of God. God took time to create you. Jesus said a word and it came to pass, and many things were made. But when it came to creation of human being, they made a meeting. Let us create man and woman in the image and likeness of God. God did not create the animals in his own image. He handed over all creation to man and gave man the woman as the helpmate and say, increase and multiply. Conquer the earth. You have to conquer the earth. You have to conquer your environment. You have to conquer your spirits and powers that are hovering around you. This is an empowerment. This is a Genesis empowerment. The Genesis empowerment is still moving around. The Genesis empowerment is still moving around. The Genesis empowerment is still on. God is alive in you. You have to energize. Be energized by the Holy Spirit. Remember the Genesis empowerment. Remember the Genesis empowerment. Increase and multiply. Conquer the earth. Yes, our families are increasing and multiplying. We are conquering the earth in many ways. We have to conquer the principalities and powers. That's the watch word, my dear brothers and sisters. Your children depend on you. When children remember that daddy and mommy are in the house, they are not afraid of anybody. They know that their daddy is very powerful. Their mommy is very powerful. But when you look around and see that you are weak, what will your children do? What will your siblings do? When you pray every time and you're still afraid, think about it. This zone needs the Holy Spirit. We have the Paraclete at our beck and call because we are operating in the flesh. We are operating in the flesh. Therefore, we need the Holy Spirit. Because the principalities and powers, they're operating both in the flesh and in the spirit. St. Paul recognized them in his work as disciples of Jesus. He was admonishing us in Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 12. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, he says, "For we are wrestling against the world rulers of this darkness, against the spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places." In Greek, principalities is understood by the word arche, meaning chief or ruler that operates in various nations, people and race, and even various religions and cults. Of course, there are evil angels that fight and oppose the veracity of God's kingdom. They promote the work of Satan as their chief. No wonder why Jesus' miracle was interpreted in Matthew 12:24 as coming from Beelzebul. Because they knew that in their own time, they have that cult of the Beelzebul. Jesus was doing his miracle. They thought that it was demon, the prince of Beelzebul, that gave Jesus that power. But Jesus was greater than all these powers and all these magicians. Because most of them, they thought that Beelzebul was the power that was reigning. But that Beelzebul was the wicked spirit. That's where all wicked spirits emanate. We can see the traces of this obstruction in the book of Daniel chapter 10 from verse 12 to 13. When an angel visited Daniel in confirmation for his prayer, he told Daniel that his answered prayers was delayed for 21 days because of battle that took place between God's angel and the devil. You see, there was a fight in heaven. We have to know this. Even Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this earth. Now look at the book of Daniel chapter 10, from verse 12 to 21. The messenger, the angelic messenger, was telling Daniel that the prayer message he was about to bring to him was delayed for 21 days because of battle that took place between God's angels and the prince of the kingdom of Persia. Look at that. At this book of Daniel chapter 10 from verse 12 to 13, one will see how Archangel Michael held the angel of messenger of message to Daniel in fighting the principalities. From book of Daniel chapter 10 from verse 20 to 21, one will also be able to have the idea of why we are in constant battle with the devil and why St. Paul enjoins us to pray in season and out of season. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 from verse 16. Rejoice always. And in verse 17, pray without ceasing. In verse 18 of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, he says, give thanks in all circumstances. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you and me. We have to understand that in this world, even though we are fighting principalities and powers, but we shall never waver. We shall never be afraid of claiming back your father's property. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't cry all the time. You can cry only to God, not to Satan. When you see the Satan, wipe away your tears and look at him. Stare at him. You can lament to God, but not to Satan. If you see your enemy, look at him. Look at her. Stare at him. Stare at her. Because Christ in you is giving any type of occult powers around you. Devil knows where to go. For instance, if you are walking along the way and a dog is pursuing you, the dog is very sensitive. Animals are sensitive. I was watching the Animal Planet, Animal Channel, and lo and behold, one of the monkeys took away the child of her mother at her back, and the monkey was laughing at the mother. When the villagers came with sticks on their hand, the monkey was climbing everywhere, and they were pursuing the monkey, and the monkey was able to drop the baby. The monkey knew that the woman was helpless. She had nothing at hand to pursue the monkey. Therefore, we have to use the name of Jesus. We have to use the name of Jesus. We have to invoke the name of Jesus at all times. That's why Jesus was telling us, pray in season and out of season. Pray, pray, pray. Call his name. Don't cry to the devil. Don't cry. Pray. You can cry to God and lament to God, but don't cry to the devil. I'm just using the image of this monkey to express how we face principalities and powers. They know when we are weak. When you are fasting, you look weak, but you are strong spiritually. You may look weak outwardly, but inwardly you are strong. The devil knows that he cannot attack you in the flesh and in spirit, because he knows that you have fortified yourself during your fasting and prayer. Devil knows when you are doing your 21 days fasting and prayer. He knows when you are doing your 9 days mass novena. He doesn't come around. He will just bypass you. Do you think that mosquito can come where there is a repellent or where there is mosquito shelters spread? They will run away. Why do we put immunization? To repel the virus and SARS. Therefore, if you receive Jesus and the devil comes and smells Jesus inside you, the devil will run and say, why did I come here? Oh, take me away from here. Take me away from here. The devil will be looking for a place to go because you are the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Fortify yourself, my dear brothers and sisters, through fasting and prayer. You have to embrace the our Lord Jesus Christ. When you are saying your rosary, you are chaining the witches and wizards. Our mother Mary is a powerful intercessor. She's a great mediatrix of our time. You have the sacramentals to fight the devil, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm coming to that place. But look at what St. Paul was telling us today in 1 Thessalonica chapter 5, verse 16. We have to pray in season and out of season. And in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2, he said, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead. And in verse 2, he said, preach the word, be prepared in season and out of season. Reprove and rebuke and encourage with every form of patience in your instruction to your people. And in verse 3 of 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 3, it says, for the time will come when men will not tolerate sound doctrine, but with itching ears, they will gather around themselves teachers to teach their own desires, teachers to suit their own desires, teachers to preach what will benefit them. Some desires are undesirable. Some desires are undesirable. Some desires are diabolic. Some desires are fetish. Some desires are ungodly. Some desires are deadly. Some desires are deceitful. Some desires are worldly. My dear brothers and sisters, you have to know what you are desiring. You have to know where you are getting your teachings. There was a young man that was looking for money at all costs, and went to the devil. And the devil gave him money at all costs. And when the devil made demand to kill the mom, it dawned on the man that this was not something that he could come out from. He cried. And eventually gave the devil the mother. He killed his mother. And look at, devil started torturing him. Who will he share the money with? Who he called mother? And after killing the mother, devil was still demanding his brothers. Devil was still demanding his sisters. And this man wanted to kill himself. That was when I was at the Navy. He came to the office and was crying. People gathered together. And they were listening to his testimony. I killed my mom. He killed his mom. And the devil was demanding his own brother. His only brother. He couldn't go home further. And people, the charisma, that's why there is power of intercession. I called the charismatics. They gathered around him. And they were praying for him. That was when the guy said he had inner peace. All this while he was living in money, he didn't even want to go into his sky again. He didn't want to do anything with the devil again. He didn't want money again. He preferred to walk on the feet, on his 2 feet. But before, he was looking for money. Money is the root of all evil. Devil will bring you closer. Devil may give you all you want. The devil will demand something that you won't like. In Gospel of Mark chapter 1 verse 35, showed us how Jesus was fortifying his weak apostles, because he knew that the apostles were still apprentices. They were still like seminarians. And Jesus was showing us how to fortify ourselves and our weak brothers and sisters. In Gospel of Mark chapter 1 from verse 35. How did he do that? Jesus went early in the morning. He stepped out from the house to pray. While the apostles were still resting, he would step out from the house and go to a quiet mountain to pray. Gospel of Mark chapter 1 verse 35. You can imagine when we went to Jericho, we went to Mount Horeb, we went to Mount Olivet. We saw how the place was. Now there were electricities around. But you can imagine the time of Jesus Christ. No electricity. And he was comfortable on the mountain at that early morning. You know, sometimes early in the morning, you still have darkness. But Jesus was able to go to the mountain to pray. Have you ever heard that Jesus was sick? Have you ever heard that the apostles were sick in the Bible? Because they were with Jesus. Jesus conquered everything. When you are with Jesus, you are not sick. When you are with Jesus, nothing, no occultic power torment you. Jesus was covering the apostles. And so tonight, Jesus is covering us in this line in Jesus' name. Jesus is teaching us how to embrace him and be alive and safe. Jesus was still praying in the dark. No electricity in his own time. No plant. But he still made it onto the mountain. Compare the mountain with the type of churches we have now. And also the comfort of our houses and the chapel we have in our houses and our altar. These are quiet places we have with our God, compared to that of Jesus Christ during his own time going to the mountain to pray. You can imagine that. In Gospel of Matthew chapter 6 from verse 9 to 13, he taught the apostles how to pray. He was handing over to the apostles the shield of divine protection. The shield of divine protection. He taught them how to pray. Sometimes when you give a child of God a place to read in the Bible, oh, Father, I have finished reading it. Oh, I'm still reading the one Owakwe gave me. Oh, Father, I have finished reading. You are reading. I want you to pray the Bible. I want you to listen to the word of God talk to you. I want you to listen to the word of God talk to you. And when the word of God is talking to you, and you are listening, you are contemplating on the word of God, it is going through your whole self. You are digesting the word. And you are making it your own. And that's how to feed your body and your spirit with the word of God. When the word of God has soaked you, as if to say, you are putting bread inside the tea. When you put bread inside the tea, it will soak the whole tea. Allow the word of God to soak you well. When you are soaked with the word of God, how would the devil come? Because you are now fortified. But when you just read it, you rattle through the prayers and finish it and close the Bible, you don't even remember one verse, one chapter. No word. You don't even contemplate on one. No word resonates with you. You haven't prayed. Make the word of God your own. And then when you are moving out from your house, you know that you are taking something along with you. That's how to protect yourself. That's how to fortify yourself. Jesus taught his apostles how to pray. And at the end of the prayer, he said, "And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from every evil." Jesus knew that there is temptation. Jesus knew about the evil one. So for us, we have to be aware of the principalities and powers and how they operate. Then know how to avoid them. When I was a parish priest in one parish, I won't call the name of the town and parish, I was converting many of the occultic members to Christianity and some of the witches and wizard members revolted. They planned. They came to the father's house in different shape and form. But Jesus arrested them. Their leader came, one of them. She came in. Immediately, the woman stepped into the father's house, because in every father's house, we place a crucifix on top of the door. When you're entering, if you look at every father's house, you see crucifix. If you go into the hospital, the Catholic hospital, you see crucifix in every room. We mark every room with the cross of Jesus, the crucifix of Jesus Christ. The church knows why she does that. We mark every place with the crucifix of Jesus. So when this woman stepped into the parlor, the boys told me that somebody was waiting for me in the parlor. And the person that was waiting for me was uncomfortable. The person was fidgeting and rolling on the ground. I said, "Mother, what is going on?" He said that I told them not to send me here. I told them, "Who told you? Who were you telling? Who are you? Father, you will not understand. These people have killed me. Father, don't kill me. Don't pour your holy water on me. Please, Father, forgive me." I said, "You haven't done anything." No, Father, I did. It is still in my word, in my thought. Hey, Father. I said, "I haven't even thought." I told them, "This man is not just ordinary priest. He's not ordinary priest. He's like Abala." I was just looking at this woman. My boss, we are laughing at him. They didn't know what was going on. And she told me that very day, "Father, when they bring fish for you in the evening for bazaar, please don't eat it." "When they bring the fruits, please don't eat this one. The only one that you'll be eating is the one that came through the offertory, because Jesus is in the church." Look at that. They know where to bring it, and they know when and how to maneuver. They reveal their secret. Let me tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, when you are walking with the Lord, God will walk with you, but will not for you. One of the agents entered into the parlor, and Jesus arrested her. And she started revealing a lot. "I was sent to give you food, so that when you eat, you will be sleepy during the evening adoration." But she did not know what happened to her when she stepped into the Father's house. Let me tell you, children of God, the devil is still afraid of Jesus. And the devil is afraid of the baptized children. Because you are carrying the light and banner of Lord. The devil still knew the power of Jesus. The devil still knew the power that Jesus possessed. Now look at Philippians chapter 2, verse 10. "At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth." And in verse 11, says, "Every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father." In Gospel of Matthew chapter 8, verse 29, when Jesus arrived at the region of Gadarene, two demons that possessed two men, they were there. And Jesus was on his way. Jesus was about to pass that way. And these two demonic men were on their way from the tomb, because they always sleep in the tomb. They don't sleep where men sleep. They sleep in the tomb. You can imagine somebody sleeping in the tomb. And we are told how violent these men were. But when they saw Jesus, they were shouting, "Oh, when I come into your presence, I'm so happy. When I come into your presence, I am so glad. For in your presence, there is anointing. And the Spirit of the Lord surrounds me. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke." Look at these people saw Jesus. And they were fidgeting and shouting. They were uncomfortable. When the devil sees the children of God, the devil will be uncomfortable in Jesus' name. Because you are carrying the banner of the Lord. These two demonic men were uncomfortable. And they were shouting, "Have you come to torment us before the time?" Which means they knew that their time were to end that day. Devil knew that they knew when to strike. Devil knew when to strike. Devil knows every time. But the master of every time was to pass that day. You can imagine, if Jesus did not pass that day, many people would have been wounded or tortured or tormented by this wicked demonic cult. But Jesus was to pass that day and crush them and annihilate them from the face of the earth. And that's how Jesus will be fighting for us. When Jesus steps into your life, the demonic plan of the enemy ends. Therefore, I command all that are tormented by any occultic power in the name of Jesus to be set free in this line. To be set free on this line. Be set free in your houses. Be set free in your life and in your job in Jesus' name. I command that principalities and occultic power to leave that body now in Jesus' name. That body belongs to Jesus. You are listening to me. All the diabolic forces in the line that have been possessing my children, I command in the name of Jesus to leave that body. Why will my child be tormented and tortured for life? Devil is a liar. Leave that body now. I command you in the name of Jesus to leave that body you have been torturing and possessing in Jesus' name. Leave that body now. Leave that body now. Leave that house now. In the name of Jesus, you are hearing my voice. In the name of Jesus, I command you to leave that body now. You are listening to me now. Child of God, allow that devil to leave you. Allow that devil to leave you. And believe that it has gone out of you in Jesus' name. Don't pet and massage that devil. Allow it to go away from you. Surrender. Surrender. Surrender to Jesus. And allow that devil to move. Take a deep breath and relax your nerves wherever you are. And allow that devil to move away and go to the ocean where it belongs. In the name of Jesus, right now. I'm commanding to your houses one by one in the name of Jesus to leave my daughter alone, to leave my sons alone, to leave my daughters alone, to leave that house alone in Jesus' name. Yes, it's going away now. I command that monitoring spirit to leave that child of God alone in Jesus' name. I pray that you leave you alone. Your sickness is gone in Jesus' name. For you're a child of God. You are destined to succeed. All the agents of Satan, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you leave them, amen. They will not possess you again. In the name of Jesus, you will not be afraid again. For Jesus has come to take back what belongs to him. Jesus is in your life. Jesus is in your life. Jesus is in your life. You are no longer under the devil's influence tonight in Jesus' name. Just allow the devil to go away from your body. Allow that monitoring spirit to go away from you, to no longer possess you again in Jesus' name. You cannot cripple the children of God again. Your power will be powerless in the name of Jesus. Go away from that body in Jesus' name. Yes, I'm commanding you in the name of Jesus to get away from all those bodies. We are told that in verse 30 that the demons begged Jesus where to place them as they leave the body they were possessing. Look at when Jesus was commanding the devil and the demons to leave the body of those possessed men in Gospel of Matthew chapter 8 from verse 29 to 30, we are told that these men, you know, the devil was speaking. The devil was speaking through those men. And the devil was begging Jesus to place them inside the pig. At least for the first time, Jesus answered the prayer of the devil. And Jesus was able to place those devils into the pigs and enter the swine. The devil left the bodies of those men that they were possessing. Remember, in verse 29, they recognized Jesus and said, "What do you want with us, Son of God? What do you want with us, Son of God?" Which means that they know Jesus. They know Jesus. They know the children of God. We are called Christians because we are following Christ. Remember this. We are called Christians because we are following Christ. So the devil and the occultic world, they know us. Even in your village and town, they know the genuine ones. They know the churchgoers and the people that are really Christians. They know. They will say, "Don't mess up with this woman. Don't mess up with this man. Don't go to this man. Don't go to this woman." The devil knows. And the occultic world knew everything. Because God is with you. Which means that the agents of Satan knows the children of God. You are the divine instrument. Know this. Always bear in mind that you are the divine instrument. That's what you are. You have to be aware of this and then stand firm in spite of what you are going through. How? First, be aware of your environment. Two, do not panic. Three, be ready to stand your ground. Four, never give those psychological forces the power to eat you up. Are you listening to me? Five, talk to your inner self to be calm. Talk to your inner self to be calm. Remember 1 Peter chapter 5 from verse 8 to 10. Be calm but vigilant. Because your enemy, the devil, is prowling like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Stand up to him strong in faith. Number six points. Tell yourself to be still because you are Jesus who will rescue your situation. If Jesus could calm down the wave of the ocean, Jesus will calm down your own wave. You have to know this. You have to know that our God is with you. Tell yourself to be still because your Jesus will rescue your situation. You remember the book of Daniel chapter 3 verse 18 about Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. They challenged the king and his pagan cult. "Be it known to you, O king, that we will not serve your gods nor worship your cult." In verse 17 of book of Daniel chapter 3, "The God we serve is able to deliver us from this burning, fiery furnace." Let me tell you, child of God, you may find yourself in a fiery furnace in one way or the other. But I'm reassuring you that help is on the way. As you are listening to this message now, close your eyes. Pause for a while. And embrace the strength of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I cast out the demonic cult that has been tormenting you in your life. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke that evil forces that has subdued you and subjected you for long. In the name of Jesus, I rescue you from that cult of the enemy. That evil forces that have deprived you of your job, that evil forces that have deprived you of your freedom, your happiness, I come against them with the power of the Holy Spirit, with the cult of Jesus. You have to believe, because Jesus told us in Gospel of John, chapter 20, from verse 22 to 23, to receive the Holy Spirit, Jesus breathed the Spirit upon his apostles. Gospel of John, chapter 20, from verse 22 to 23, he said, receive the Holy Spirit. Whatever you bless is blessed. And whatever you cast away, cast away. And also give them the power to forgive sin. You have to understand this, that God has empowered human beings to have that power to forgive, have that power to cast away. I command all these principalities and powers to leave that body, to leave that house, and go to the ocean where they belong, in Jesus' name. Also, in every Mass, if you're a Catholic, after the consecration and the Lord's Prayer, you hear the prayer of deliverance. Take that prayer very serious, especially when you feel that you are tormented or tortured by the principalities and powers. Anytime you attend Mass, be very attentive. Follow very well. Listen to the power of consecration. When Jesus had come in a special way, carry yourself and your body to Jesus. And when they are saying the Our Father, the prayer that Jesus taught his apostles, take in deep breath and breathe out and relax your nerves and allow Jesus to encapsulate your being. And when the Catholic priest is saying the prayer of deliverance, allow yourself to be delivered. Sometimes you start looking for someone to it is Jesus that delivers. Deliverance can occur to you when you are listening to Mass, even on television. Deliverance can come to you even during the Mass you attended. And also, deliverance can come to you when the intercessors are praying for you. It is left for you to avail yourself of the opportunity to be delivered. Sometimes people tighten themselves and they don't know how to loosen themselves. So that deliverance will have that efficacy upon you. It is Jesus that delivers. Remember that the Word of God is alive and active. Hebrews 4:12. Remember that the Word of God is God. That's why after everything they say, the Word of God, we say, thanks be to God. Before you are protected from anything, you have to make effort to understand the nature of what you are fighting and what you are being protected from. People build fences and put iron doors and gates in their houses against burglary. At least you make it difficult for robbers to come in. The same in the health sector. We immunize ourselves. We immunize our children and ourselves against infection and other diseases. These are many ways we fight virus and flu with flu shots. In the scripture, we have the power of the incarnate word. In the scripture, we have the power of the incarnate word. Jesus Christ, the word that was used to create the world. John 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. If the Word was God, Then invoke the word. That is Jesus. In your critical moment. And be convinced of what you are saying and what is ministered to you by either a priest or intercessor. When the occultic world use their incantations against you, fight back with the name of Jesus, that is the Word. Jesus is the Word. Word is Jesus. Remember, Matthew 24:35, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word will never pass away. Use the powerful words of the past, of the Psalms, to fight the powerful words of Satan. Use the powerful words of the Psalms to fight the powerful words of Satan. And use the words from the scripture to strengthen your faith. Jesus knows how to torment the cult of the occult. As we can see in Gospel of Matthew, chapter 8, from verse 29 to 30. The devil knows the time to strike, and Jesus knows the time to remove them before they strike. You can imagine what would have happened if Jesus did not pass at that hour. Look at that. We have to learn from Jesus how to time the occultic powers. That's why we have hours of prayer. St. Paul's letter to Corinthians, chapter 8, verse 26, understood our frailty. There are certain situations that may not allow us to put to words all our petitions. So St. Paul encourages us that the Spirit of God helps us in our infirmities. If we know not what to say, we should pray for, even when we are praying and our prayers are murmured, the Spirit directs even our murmured prayer to be edifying in the eyes of the Lord. With the groanings which cannot be uttered. In Matthew chapter 11, verse 25 to 26, it shows how secretive Jesus and the Father were. I thank you, Father, and I praise you for hiding these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to little children. And I add, for hiding it from the occultic world. Yes, Father, for this was your good and pleasurable moment. And it is pleasing to you to hide it from the occultic people. Our God is very secretive. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 2 to 4, even when you give alms, don't reveal it. That shows us how secretive God is and how secretive Jesus is. Even our Igbo culture shares this aspect of divine secrecy. If you continue to beat your heart, you tell your enemy where your weakness or sickness is, and your enemy will attack you. Jesus, in Matthew chapter 14, verse 23, went back to the mountain side by himself to pray alone. He's encouraging us how to pray. He's encouraging us to pray every time. If you look at Gospel of Luke chapter 6, verse 12, he said he prayed at night. He knows the time to fight the devil. He knows the time when they come. The Greek word for power is exousia. Means conferred authority. Devil lost authority. That's why he was taking Jesus around. Go to the pinnacle of the church. I'm showing him the whole world and so on. Devil loves to command authority, and devil is happy when we are bowing before him. And when the children of the light comes to the occultic meetings and go to the witches and wizards to fortify themselves. We are carrying the Christian name and going to the devil. Devil always laugh at us and welcome us very fast. Devil welcomes Christians very fast because he wants to shame Jesus Christ. He said, look at your Christians, they are coming to me. They are no longer with you. That's why Jesus said, if you deny me on earth, I will deny you in heaven. the fruit of the powers can be seen in the gangsters and in our campuses, among the wealthy ones around the world. People that don't understand the full operation of the principalities and powers enter into the cult out of desperation. And when they have entered, they want to come out. It becomes a struggle. Today, Jesus is placing a hedge of divine protection upon you. Even though he mentioned that his kingdom is not of this world. In John chapter 18:36, but he created the world and knows that we are still here in this world. So he is empowering us with the Gospel of Mark chapter 16 verse 17. We are the believers. And in verse 16, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. But whoever does not believe will be condemned. In verse 17, these signs will accompany you, especially those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. And I add, you shall also conquer the occultic power. If you can drive out demons, you can also conquer the principalities and powers in your life. You can speak in many tongues. You can pick up snakes as Moses did with his staff and son. You can do many things in the name of the Lord when God is with you. And when you lay hands on people, they will get well. So my children, look at Jesus empowering us in Gospel of Mark chapter 16 verse 17. At your own covenant, I look at it. And so I place my hands of anointing upon each and every one of us in this line. I invoke the spirit of the 12 apostles upon you to echo the voice of deliverance upon you. In the name of Jesus, be delivered. In the name of Jesus, be delivered. In the name of Jesus, be free from your from all principalities and powers that have been tormenting your family in Jesus' name. When you are struggling with occultic powers, you are like someone eating a soup full of bones, and you are using your tongue to sort them out. The church knows why she has sacramentals. It bears the name and image of Jesus Christ. During the Exodus in the Old Testament, God introduced the blood of the unblemished lamb, thereby ushering the blood of his son, Jesus Christ, as the Lamb of God, that will also save us. God knew where the enemies were during the time of the Israelites, and still gave them the injunction to place the blood of the lamb at the doorpost. In our own time, we have stickers and so on, and all the sacramentals. Make use of the blessed oil, the salt, and water. And also burning of your prayer candles and incense to fight the principalities and powers. According to Father William Saunders, he explained why incense was used during Mass. Herodotus, the Greek historian, recorded that it was used by Assyrians and Babylonians and Egyptians too. And in religious rites, it kept demons away. In Judaism, incense was included in the Thanksgiving offering of oil, rain, fruit, and vine. In Book of Numbers, chapter 7, from verse 13 to 17, you can read up too. And in Exodus, chapter 30, from verse 1 to 10, the Lord instructed Moses to build a golden altar for the burning of incense. We have to fortify ourselves, my dear brothers and sisters. And I pray that the oil of the wicked shall never anoint you, as said in Psalm 141, verse 5. If you place a cocoyam in front of your house and a witch is around or passing there, the person will continue to be restless and will continue to murmur and complain about it. In the same way, the incense repels the bad spirits around your house and gladdens your house, your household, with the aroma of divine protection. So be saved in Jesus' name. Let's go into prayer. Loving Father, I thank you for tonight, for blessing my children with your word. Your word is alive and active. I stretch out my blessing hands upon my children tonight. I cover them with your blood, O Jesus, your precious blood. I cover them in your name, the Jesus, the Emmanuel, God with us. I pray for divine protection to be upon you one by one. I pray for divine anointing to flow. Let the anointing flow. Anointing of divine protection against principalities and powers. All those principalities and powers, the PPs, God is greater than them because God is the awesome God. He's the super. He supersedes everything because our God is the great fascination, the summum bonum of our life, the ens mobile sensibile. I pray for divine protection upon you, for you are the child of God, you are the children of the light, you are following the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and end of your life. So do not be afraid, child of God, because God is in your life. God has come to rescue you tonight. God is the deliverer. God is the deliverer. When God delivers, he does not come back. The Satan runs away. We didn't even hear that those demonic attack that came to those men came back to those men. Oh, Jesus commanded them to enter the swine, and they left those men. I pray tonight that those monitoring spirits will leave your house. Those monitoring spirits will leave that child of God. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. God has come to arrest the situation in your life. God has come to take possession of what belongs to him. Because you belong to the occult, to the cult of Jesus, not to the cult of the satanic world. I pray for deliverance for you. I pray for divine anointing upon you. Psalm 141 verse 5 says, you will never be anointed by the wicked. And so there's no witches and wizards that will hover around your house again, both in dream and in daylight. Tonight is your night of deliverance, the night of your protection, the night of your protection, the night of your deliverance in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I pray that you continue to be under the protection of divine anointing, because the anointing flows and anointing breaks the yoke. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, our Daddy, our King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days. There is no one that's like you, O God. Be thou glorified in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We cover this message with the blood of Jesus. We pray that the message we have received will remain in our hearts and bear fruit in our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, Lord, we lift your son to you, whom you have used to bless your people with your word. Father, may you bless him. May you strengthen him. May you fortify him. Father, take him to places, O Lord, O Jesus. Father, fight his battle. Visit him at the point of need, O Lord. Enlarge his course, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We give you all the glory, Father, for we know you have answered us. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.